I'm just busting out. I'm not gonna lie. Sneakle. Shit, I just ran across this guy on YouTube, and I was gonna, you know, do a video on negative environment. I want to do reaction videos off of it so I can, you can hear their story, something that's similar, because shit, probably their story relate more than mine can. But, you know what I mean? These videos are just, you can have just really conversation about them, just piggyback off of it and put your own thing inside of it. So, you know what I mean? We're just going to do a video that it's okay to be uncomfortable. And I'll be honest with you, when we can all agree on this. You grow when you're uncomfortable, because now you have to adapt to a new situation, something you're not used to, which then proves to you at the end of the day that you can grow in any situation as long as you stick through it and you see the other light, bro. Everyone, I used to listen to motivational videos. I say used to because I don't do it the way I used to anymore. How they always yell, preach, and repeatedly say, being in the comfort zone kills you. It is like staying in the candy shop and doing the same thing over and over and over again. You're not really growing from it. You're actually hurting from it. You get the same results, if not times 10. It's like compound effect. If you keep eating a candy bar every single day, eventually you're going to develop the sweet tooth, which I'm not, again, I am not no doctor. So if I get anything wrong, I'm just doing my best to explain it, right? You get a sweet tooth, eventually you get a cavity, and then next thing you know, your teeth gets rotten, and then they start to fall out, and then it becomes a bigger health problem than it is from just one candy bar every single day. And that's your comfort zone. And so, and you keep telling yourself, it's okay to eat a candy. It's just one. I'm not really hurting myself. It's just one. But again, compound effect, when you do it every single day, all that little candy bar starts to add up. For every single day, that's 365 days. So you ate 365 candy bars. And you keep doing it for years and years and years. That is going to eventually show to the point where your comfortability of you eating this candy fucked you up in the long run. Same way as eating a salad every single day, which I don't know if that's healthy to eat a salad every single day. I don't know. Because eating a carrot every single day is not good. You'll be orange. That shit happened to me. Whereas, like, if you eat a salad every single day, you'll start to see the health benefits, more energy. But again, moderation. Everything comes in within moderation. It's okay to eat a candy bar, but you can't eat it too much. I mean, everything has to deal with balance. You have to balance everything out, bro. But without further ado, let's just get into this video. Almost did all. This whole
a conditional
video,
feeling of pleasurable physical ease or relief from pain about. Or stress, also known as being a lil pussy, LMAO.
During the footage you're watching, and I just wanted to rest for a second. I'm sweaty, I'm all red, and I smell bad. But the hostess welcomed me in. The waiter showed me a table and handed me the menu, and I thought about how anyone could just walk into a diner and 9 out of 10 times get the same hospitality I got. Even you. Later, as I'm paying the bill, a homeless guy barges in with the homeless look on his face, and everyone knows something's about to go down. He's going up to every table with his hands out, and the waiters are trying to get rid of him, but they don't know how.
The guy's either really crazy or really high, or both, it doesn't matter. New Yorkers are used to pretending like they don't see crazy people, but it's impossible to pretend like you don't see him.
They still keep eating their pancakes or whatever, visibly uncomfortable, and now it was decision time for me. Do I knock this guy out, or do I just leave the restaurant?
But I decide to tell him exactly what he wants to hear. Let's go to an ATM.
The hostess silently thanks me, and I walk outside with my new friend. Thing is, I had no intention of giving him any money. Sometimes I do, but threatening suicide is a dick move, no matter how homeless you are. I tell him I'll get him something to eat, but I'm not giving you any money. He starts freaking out again and gets on his knees begging me. It's pathetic. I say it again. I'm not giving you any money. Then the asshole gets up and lays down face first in the middle of the street. If I wanted to raise the stakes of the story, I would say that cars were whizzing by and I had to yank him out to save his life, but obviously everyone sees him and it was a red light.
But even the people in the cars are nervously avoiding eye contact.
So now I'm kind of responsible for this situation. And
let me pause right here. Bro, shout out to this guy. I'm not going to lie to you. He's like the most blunt guy so far. But yeah, New York City. This is something like, I'm not going to lie to you. New York City is a heavily populated area. It's very small. New York City is it's smaller than motherfuckers really think. with the amount of people there is, it's really tiny. But New York itself is a huge fucking state, which is kind of crazy. The fact that we could literally see a homeless man and just ignore him, that's, it's, to me, this is just my opinion. It's not, there's no right or wrong. To me, it's just fucked up. You know what I mean? Because you never know anybody's situation. You never know anybody's situation. And just helping someone just a little bit, you don't have to help them, like, get a house and this, that, and the third. It's, you don't have to go to the extreme, but you can do as much as you possibly can for that one person. Shit, even if it's giving a homeless person a dollar, but giving them food. But I see where he's going from with the suicide thing, but I'm not really leading off of that. I'm saying, like, the fact that we try to ignore them as if they don't exist no more or something is wrong with them is kind of fucked up, if we really think about it. Because I want you to put yourself in that person's shoes, or something similar, where you're basically asking for help at this point. You're asking for help at this point. But everyone sees that you need help, but they just turn the eye. Like, they don't know who you are. They try to live their life knowing that you're there, but you're not there. But they're very uncomfortable because they have to try and keep this act as if you're not there. What will go through your mind? What will go through your mind? Like, holy shit, what, am I a burden to society? This, that, and the third? What the fuck is going on? And am I helpless? Do I need to fix something about me? Like, why the fuck are people treating me as if I'm not them no more? Am I some type of savage that is in a form of a human or something? Like, there's so many things that run through my mind when you put yourself in that type of situation. So it's like what I'm really trying to say is basically, if you was in a situation where you needed help, and you tried to do it yourself, but it just wasn't working out, you would want people to at least acknowledge and point you in a direction that you probably didn't see at one point that'll help you out. It may not help you out dramatically, but it's one path that's leading to something bigger in the end. You know what I mean? And it's like, if everyone looked in situations like that, and this also goes for the people who are mostly like to themselves and shit like that. It's like, you don't have all the answers, but there's someone out there who can help you out with something. That little thing is something. Because, like, think of it in compound effect. Everything adds up in the end. And I'm, like, in the eyes of a homeless person, if a homeless person is, you know, in their situation, and I'm not going to lie, there's a couple scam homeless people. Some motherfuckers do that as don't be homeless at all. But that's a whole nother topic for a whole nother day. But it's like, what advice? Ask yourself when you're not in their situation. Besides money, because it's basically giving him a fish and not teaching the person how to fish. What advice can you give to this person that he or she could take and probably get 1% better with their life? You know what I mean? So if you see a homeless person, yes, you could give him that dollar. But what else could you give that person? Hey man, there's a homeless shelter over here that gives out classes. I don't know if homeless shelters do this, but they give out these classes and they can try to help you out. Or if you're a teacher, hey man, I schedule these types of classes for X, Y, and Z. We help with X, Y, and Z. If you want to join, you feel free to come by. We're at this part. We'll be here at this time. This. If it's a paid class, you'll be coming in for free. We are an open group. We don't judge. You know what I mean? Imagine how you make that person feel. The fact that you made him feel like, he or she feel like there's something, there's somebody at this point. Like, I don't see you for what everyone is labeling you as, a homeless person, which is technically true, but at the same time, we're not going to get into these conversations, actually. But you know what I mean? I'm not going to see you for what this is, because this is not who you truly are. There's more to you. You just had an unfortunate event. God damn. What am I saying? You know what I'm saying? Now, I mean, it's okay to treat everyone equal. It's not okay to treat someone as if they're beneath you, or, you know what I mean? What can you really pass on to someone else to help them get 1% better every single day? What can you pass? Like, really think about that. Ask yourself. You know, everyone on this planet has something they can pass on to somebody that can help them get 1% better every single day. Everybody. Let's get into this video.
Instead of walking away like I usually would, I drag him back on the street by his feet. He's yelling from the ground, please, please, I gotta get out of here. And I look to my right and I see everyone from the diner staring at us out the window like it's a movie. I had enough. This is not my problem. I put in my headphones and walk away. People are afraid to be uncomfortable. I'm not talking about stressed or anxious. I mean uncomfortable. It started when schools added safe spaces.
A good idea in theory, but are the rainbows really necessary?
Then schools added therapy dogs, which I'm not against. Everyone likes petting a dog.
But do we really have to call them fucking therapeutic? They're dogs. They're just dogs.
They're not licensed practitioners. They don't have PhDs.
Hello?
They're fucking dogs.
You're not having a mental breakdown because you have some homework.
A guy who puts a knife to his throat in a diner could maybe use a safe space or a therapy dog, but
you don't need a mental health day because you're tired.
Later, after the homeless incident.
I want to know if I should get into that one, but I probably might do it anyway, bro. Because I agree to disagree. And it goes in so many ways. Let's just finish this video.
Incident. I'm waiting for the train to arrive, just scrolling, and I hear the lady next to me talking on the phone go,
oh, he better not jump on the tracks or I'm gonna be late. I look up and I think, no way. And I see crazy homeless guy dangling half torso into the tracks, looking around for some sympathy money.
It's a depressing scene to keep seeing, but it's also kind of funny.
This is the third time in maybe 2 hours that I've seen this guy try a different way to kill himself. You gotta give him props for creativity, yo. Other homeless people, you gotta step your game up, man.
Let me stop right there for that one right there. Cause he says something right there, like sympathy for money. So, like, a lot of us do that. You know that, right? Not for money, but just in general. We do things not for money. Shit, some of y'all started OnlyFans for money. I ain't do that shit because that's y'all passion. But that's you know what I'm saying? We do things for attention. Unnecessary amount of attention at that. We'll do, or clout, or is what people would say. We'll do shit that's just unnecessary. Like, I can give an example. Holy shit, it's actually a funny one. But it's not going to be funny the way I'm going to explain it. So I was on the bus. This was when I was in New York. And these kids started just roasting this bald man. They said he had baby oil on his head and they wanted to slap the back of his head. He's an Uber driver. Oh my God. There was just so much they said to him that was just unnecessary for a couple of laughs. You know, like with his little group and shit. And I'm in the back cracking up because I'm not going to lie, the jokes were funny, but now when I think about it and after hearing this, it's like, what was the point of that? And I'm listening to the story of him saying, you know, this homeless, that better not be my fucking tire, boy. Snigga dog. Got off its leash. I thought that was my tire. I was about to say. But What was I saying before I thought my tire got stolen? I think we do. Boom. How the homeless man is doing things just for money. You know what I mean? And it's just like, it goes back to what I'm saying. It's like, they only see one part. They're in the storm. Think of it of them in the storm and you're outside of the storm. You see multiple ways that you can help this situation out or things that you will do differently, right? Instead of watching them be in the eye of the storm or in like stuck in the storm, not knowing what to do. So they're stuck with this one image they see. And just they keep doing it. You keep doing it. Why can't you pass on your information and shit? That doesn't really make sense with the story that I told with the guy telling jokes. It kind of does. He didn't really need to make those people laugh. We're going to move on. But why not give some type of advice that can change this person's view on their actions that they're taking and direct it somewhere else where they'll probably get a different result? You know what I mean? A guy is homeless. Cool. Whatever. But that doesn't mean he can just stay homeless forever. Everybody's situation can change. Not everyone was born rich. We can hands down say there's a lot of self-made millionaires or self-made people out there. I'm not saying they don't do this, but why can't some people out there, you don't even have to be a millionaire. You can just be someone who changed your situation. Why can't you pass on some type of advice or give some type of tutorial, or give some type of light to someone that could use it? Because you can give a homeless person money every fucking time you see them. Nothing is going to change. Unless that homeless person is really saving all that money up and getting a house. But how are they going to pay for it with no job? You know what I mean? It's like, what can you do to help this person get out their situation? And that is something uncomfortable, because when someone see a homeless person, I don't know what goes through their mind. Probably the smell. I mean, the smell is horrendous, but they haven't showered. What do you expect? Well, how would you smell if you didn't shower for a fucking month? How would you smell? You know what I mean? So, man, we gonna finish watching this video.
There's maybe 50 people, but of course, no one is doing shit. They're all acting like they don't notice, standing off to the side. I get up and talk the guy off the ledge. Then some lady gives him a 20 and he runs off. He might have killed himself. I don't care. I did my part. Also, there's a lot to unpack here, because it's just unbelievable how passive everyone around me was. They were all uncomfortably standing there like it was someone else's problem. The lady on the phone next to me wasn't even scared. She would just rather complain about a train delay because of a mangled homeless body than just talk to him for a second. I'm different. I'm okay with awkward situations because I know it'll make for a great story.
Most people see the suicidal homeless guy and just want to go home.
I would have been a bystander a couple years ago until I realized that the feeling of uncomfortable is the most effective way to learn about yourself. You'll learn about what you're afraid of, and you'll learn about what makes you feel comfort. You don't grow when you're comfortable. I was in college for 2 years, not because I was learning, not because it was going to get me a job, but because it provided a sense of security. You wake up, you go to class, get drunk, and cheat on the test. Everyone else was in the same boat, so it didn't feel weird. I knew that I wanted to quit, but I didn't want to lose that sense of comfort. I'm so afraid to lose another 2 years that now I specifically go out of my comfort zone.
I started doing stand-up comedy, and I've bombed so hard.
All right, let me stop right there because he's talking about something else. Did I say some of that? Comment down below if I said something like that. You don't grow in the comfort zone. I definitely want to talk about the stability thing, because I did door-to-door sales. It's crazy because every single day you're selling to someone. Every single day. It doesn't matter what it is, whether you're a salesman or not. You're selling every single day. In the job, when you do interviews, you would have to sell the fact that it's 100% commission. At the time, when I was doing this, it's 100% commission. There is no guaranteed paycheck that you'll be seeing every single week of a certain amount of dollars. It's not guaranteed at all. And some people are coming off of jobs where it's like, damn, but I was making 400 and da-da-da-da-da a week and da-da-da-da. And so why are you here? Because I wasn't making enough money, da-da-da-da. But now it's like, I have control of my money, but what if I don't make money? What happens if I don't sell anything? What do you think? You don't make money. So what is that going to force you to do? Work harder. But here's the thing. Some people, like in the other videos with the whole fat thing, some people don't want to hear that shit. You have to sugarcoat it. It's like, I mean, some shit like, I mean, you don't really have to worry about that because the worst person in the office makes 10 sales or da-da-da-da. Like, if you don't sell, you don't sell. Why wouldn't you sell? It's because your attitude is off or you didn't try hard enough. I mean, there's going to be days where you don't sell. I mean, Nobody's perfect. That's what you got to understand. There's 7 days in a week. If you fuck up on one day, that doesn't determine your next day or the next day or the next day or the next. That was just one day. How you take that information and run with it is on you. You can determine if that's going to be your year, your month. You determine that shit. You know what I mean? I did that shit for a year, and I'm not going to hold you. I did not fucking like it at all. But I definitely was not going to leave the field without making some fucking money in my pocket. I'm not going to lie. The fact that I can control it, I've made $1,000 checks. I made $2,000 checks. Okay. You know what I mean? Like, you could do this shit. When I sit here and say, everyone that's going to be watching this video in the future, because again, I know I'm going to be a big YouTuber. When I tell you guys could be anything you want to be in this life, you could do anything you want in this life. You honestly can. If you want to be a billionaire, you could be a billionaire. A millionaire, you can be a millionaire. If you want 10 cars, you can own 10 cars. If you want to be a rapper, you can be a rapper. If you want to be an artist, you can be an artist. If you want to be a graphic designer, you could do anything you want to do in this life. 100%. But you can't do that if you're going to be in the comfort zone and keep doing the same thing over and over and over and over again. You have to literally start shifting towards the things that will lean to the things you really want to do. I wanted to do YouTube for a long time. A long time. Since MW 2 days, I've been wanting to record videos and post it on YouTube. I just wasn't comfortable enough. And I knew I wasn't comfortable enough. I could have had the equipment. I was scared of the camera. I had a chipped tooth at one point. I was super fat. I was not confident in myself at all. I'm telling y'all this straight up because at this point, I don't really care. This is my story. It's to the point where it's like, how long am I going to let all my flaws prevent me from things I really want to do? Because let's say I actually did YouTube when I was fat. I had a chipped tooth right here. What would have been different? I still would have been the same me. If my image is flawed, then it's flawed to me. It's not really flawed to you because, again, it has nothing to do with you, as the other videos say. It doesn't make me less human from you. It doesn't change me in any way, shape, or form. You know what I mean? It just never mattered. You know, and then you as you age, you start to regret, like, damn, what if I had just took that step when I was ready to take that step? Where would I be today? You know what I mean? So it's like, I ask myself, what if I had got uncomfortable sooner? Where would I have been? Where would I have been right now? Where would I be to this day? I would never know. But that's what triggers me to always do things now, immediately. Like things that I know I could do. Like that's going to benefit me. Not shit like get a car. Like get a Hellcat tomorrow because shit. What if I miss out on a Hellcat? It's a fucking external thing that means absolutely nothing. It's a vehicle. Eventually that shit is going to come. We all know eventually our shit is going to come. It comes within time. But I got to start getting busy. I got to start getting active. I got to start doing things I never wanted to do before. Trust me when I said a motherfucker hated the camera. I'm not going to say I'm 100% comfortable, but I got used to it at this point. It's a camera. I'm sharing my story. This is the best way I can share my story before I end up being on stage with a big-ass microphone in my hand in a sold-out arena saying the same thing I'm saying on this camera on stage. You know, so let's get in this video. Ooh, nice charger.
As soon as I said the charger passed by, one passed, man. I started modeling and even got signed to an agency, which has been humbling for my ego. I know it sounds like I'm bragging. I'm not, because I'm horrible at it. I look like
Zoolander in every picture. I only got signed because racially ambiguous is trendy right now.
There ain't shit left to expose. People have yelled at me on stage when I'm telling my terrible jokes.
The gay guys in the fashion industry were the first people to call me fat.
If you thought it, I heard it. But I don't want to live scared anymore. No way I'm going to tell a story as one of the bystanders.
Thanks to today's sponsor, The Wavelights. It's from thewavelights.com.
That was the video? Damn, I thought that whole extra minute would have been him shitting and shit. But yeah, I agree with him, man. I don't want to live scared anymore. And you shouldn't either. There's no reason to be scared. There's no reason to be scared whatsoever. What are you possibly... What are you scared of? What's going to happen if you try to open up a business? What's going to happen if you try to talk to that girl or guy? What's going to happen if you... If you just... If you do something you're not used to doing, what's really going to happen? Something that might better you. What's going to happen if you confront the problem? You know what I mean? You're not going to die. Shit, unless, motherfucker, you're confronting a nigga that wants to kill you. But shit, violence is not the answer. And that's, again, a whole nother topic for a whole nother video. Violence is actually like nope, wait. We can bring it back. But we're not. But like, really ask yourself, what do you have to be scared of? You're gonna be uncomfortable regardless. When I moved to PA for the first time, and there's a story behind that. I actually got kicked out the house and I had to move to PA. No job, just got a car, so now I'm questioning, how am I gonna pay the car, how am I gonna pay the insurance, and how am I gonna get a job? You know what I mean? Because getting a job in New York blew my fucking brains apart. I didn't have enough on my resume to get a job. So what am I really going to do? Got a job. Life was a little bit different. I was uncertain, but shit, I had to do something. I couldn't be in a I didn't have a comfort zone. So I had to do something. I had to develop something. And from there, I just kept growing and growing and growing. Now I'm in Buffalo. Same thing applies. Well, I didn't get kicked out. This time I actually moved here, but same thing applies. You know what I mean? Now I'm about to work at a dealership. Chevrolet, by the way. You get your ZL1s through me. Just like that. I mean, in life, if you're always looking for the stable route, and there's nothing wrong with that, by the way. If you want to take the stable route, you can. But this is for those who want to receive the most of what they can get out of themselves in life. If you want the most, you must take that uncomfortable route every single day. Every day. You don't grow if you stay in the comfort zone. It's really that simple. When you're in the comfort zone, you're there until it goes away. So if you had that job that was giving you $70,000 every single year for 3 years in a row, then Corona hit, now you don't have a job anymore. That was the comfort zone. It don't last forever. Nothing lasts forever. Nothing lasts forever. And nothing, at the end of the day, nothing matters. So if nothing matters and nothing lasts forever, why not just do what you want to do? Why not go hard? Why not try to make shit work? Because you're not perfect and nobody on this planet is perfect. And that's what makes you you. The fact that social media at this point is trying to make everyone seem like you have to be this perfect figure to get on it. That's why I fucking hate it. Because if you have a flaw, they break you down for it. If you have a tummy, they attack you for it. If you don't have money, they holy shit, do they bash you for it. Listen to these artists, listen to these girls. Broke girls at that saying, I don't want a broke nigga. You can't, like, yo, bro, there's so much stupid shit to this world that makes no sense at this point. Like... But, you know, going back to it so I don't lose train of thought, bro. Like, there's really nothing to be scared of at this point. And again, like I said, when I say hit that subscribe button, we do this together, bro. We pass this message on together. Together. You know what I mean? So, that's really the video. I'm killing two birds, one stone, reacting while passing on the message. So, what we gonna do? You know, like, comment, subscribe, share the video to everyone that you think needs to hear this. Don't just share it just to share it. Share it to someone who needs to hear this. Share it on your Facebook. If there's a couple people on your Facebook that you would believe if they heard this message, shit would be better for them. It's just that 1% that they needed to hear to kick off something for them. Something for them. Okay? You know what I mean? And that's really much it, man. I'll see y'all in the next one.